There's a tree.
Slightly drunk on the pitch, being asked to get out his lunchbox, proceeds to get his cock out mid-pitch against Hill BB, definitely my top moment of the season.
Norbs' try-saving tackle, where he split his knee down to the bone.
Me, seventh season, Jenks hasn't scored a try. Great, well, is it? He hasn't. Line BB, gets a pop, 2 metres from the line, no one in front of him, straight on the floor.
He cried, then shat himself.
I think against Castle, last match for the Bees, Trench's dog tackle.
Stu getting yellow carded for regularly taking the piss out of the small referee.
Probably Bees and Hatfield was my favourite moment of the season.
GCRFC!
Seeing Sam Kennedy used as a bridge to get over the hedge on Iron Man.
Sam the drawbridge Kennedy.
You just saw him do like a drawbridge for the rest of them just scampering across the hedge.
Favourite social moment? I have to say the Iron Man series were very funny. Particularly enjoyed Basil with his rousing speech about the members of the club. What do you reckon, Dunks?
Fred's introduction to the saxophone was quite something, spectacular.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sam Kennedy's rendition of
him. I see you standing like greyhounds in the slips, straining at the start.
When Fred was curled up in a wheelie bin, and myself and JP had to urinate on him.
And Robert's singing. The Iron Man ceiling.
It's not unusual.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone.
When we were asked, I think you were there, we were asked to go and get a Christmas tree, expecting to come back with a twig.
Yeah.
And the shock on our social secretary's face, we came back with a full-size Christmas tree decorated for Mono's birthday.
The Brian Nik-Nak ping pong contest. A real tour de force from the Asian sportsman of the team.
Tackling 10-8 while he was covered in mustard.
Sharon?
I really like the slide, the slip and slide for the Fesh's initiation.
Slip and slide. Initiation. That was hilarious.
GCRFC!
Yeah.
Well, when Reeve got his arse out and we all realised that he had MRSA on his arse was probably the most scary moment.
Well, I'd say Mono was MVP, but he's cut. So I'm going to have to go with Jakes.
I reckon Dirty, when Newman's been a really solid player all season.
The other one's obviously Norbury, his pace on the wing and his love of the position of the wing.
Rich Brown. Rich just puts himself on the line.
I think Rich Brown had an outstanding season.
I think Stu, he's just played exceptional.
Here's for Stu Barkley.
It's going to be Stu.
I'm going to have to agree with Stu Barkley.
Stu.
Stu Barkley.
I think I'll Mercurial fullback, always making great.
Don't say it because he's sat next to me.
I think we'll have to be our captain. He's led from the front. I think he's put his body on the line constantly. And I think he's played out of his skin.
GCRFC!
Yeah!
I think I've got to go Rich Owen for BT Player of the Season.
Gareth, absolutely.
And the two Irish centres.
Oh, Paddy as well. Yeah.
Kid. Like Crouchy, I think Crouchy's really stepped up this year.
Yeah.
Oh, he's been brilliant.
Yeah. Tony the Enforcer Barrett, every single game he played, he gave it his all, played all 80 minutes, I think most of the games every season.
Tony's top moment of the season has got to be when he called his fine B team the toughest bitches around.
Yeah.
A real sassy moment there for Tony Barrett. I'd probably have to go for Dave Gunton, big player, good ball carrier. Yeah,
makes the yards every time.
Exactly. A solid player.
Dave Gunton, I'd say.
Big Dave is led from the front alongside Tony. I think he's, you know, produced a solid platform for the Paddy to play really well.
He's in.
Gareth.
Yeah, Gareth. Just
filthy,
hit.
filthy hits.
Just levelling hits on tiny fly arms.
We're just a bunch of gems, so it's hard to pick one, but I think Hemi Phillipson had a very good season. Hemi did very, very well. And an unsung hero, I think. Our most reliable player, first name in the team sheet, apart from myself.
GCRFC!
Yeah.
Considering he'd never played rugby before he came here, I think Brian was a little tiger in the loose.
George Ewan or Patrick, definitely.
Pansy.
I think Pansy.
Best fresher I think this year was probably Pansy. I think for the A's.
Yeah,
he was very good. However, I do have a most improved, and we both agreed on this.
Yeah.
Which is definitely B-Bry.
B-Bry, CEO.
Oh, of course!
coming in from across the pond.
Yeah.
And he really has taken to the game.
Yeah.
A few solid moments on the pitch.
Yeah.
Possibly hasn't had enough time to shine, but yeah, a good laugh on the pitch.
Yeah.
B-Bry has done very well.
Has.
B-Rai, just incredible throughout the season.
Brian's passing the ball backwards now. That's a really good start.
I'll have to go with B-Rai. Storming runs from the wing, super sub, breaking tackle, stepping the fullback under the post, occasionally taking the kick himself.
We're going to go with Brian. First time he tries to tackle someone, he flew into them with his studs up and kicks them in the chest, which he didn't do that at the end of the season, so I think it's only a general high gradient of improvement.
I reckon Ben Trenchard, he's come in, played everywhere, A's and B's, very good, very good. I think he'll blossom in the next few years.
Probably Trenchard from his just complete
metamorphosis from a second row into a winger, come centre, come 10, come fullback.
The people, the friends, the camaraderie of great colleagues.
Yeah, and plus the marvellous trips of JP's penis. I think that's something I'll never see again.
I don't really want to be honest. So
I'm glad I've seen
the Harry Houdini of the pop world.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm personally going to miss those, you know, late night sessions in the gym, you know, with the likes of Arthur.
And I miss just being able to be absolutely horrendous. And getting away with it.
Just the boys. Stu solid performances in socials. He really is the big lad.
Yeah,
big lad of GCRFC.
Lost the
lad. Point.
Stu's really, really good chat.
No, I miss the boys. Great times we've had. At uni rugby. And then college. No, I miss the boys. Being emotional.
Stu, the second years, the first years, playing rugby.
No, it is, it's good. I'm missing all the guys I've played rugby with and drunk with and had amazing nights out with.
Going out on a Wednesday afternoon, slacking off some lectures and running around with your mates, you know, taking the piss out of each other, just having a laugh. It's been the biggest bond, bonding experience at university. All my closest mates are in the club, and I hope they'll remain mates for a long time. Lifetime, and never let go till we're gone.